sounds good. That's a Blues Clues singing the Minish theme. Alright, so we're back again. This is going to be the last episode that me and my roommate co-narrate right now until we get back to school. So,
many more to come.
Yeah. I don't know when this will be up. Let's see, this is 10, so I just put 2, 3. So this will probably be up like the last week of July. Right now it's the it's the 8th, 7th, 8th, whatever, somewhere in there. Whatever day it is. But I just figured I'd narrate them. Plus I'm with my roomie, so we're going to co-narrate. So, I'm going to add in this video, I'm going to put in the description in 9, but, that giant, huge, long, non-existent sound between, 2, like, 2:13 and, like, 8 minutes, yeah, that's us washing, cereal bowls upstairs. We're staying at a friend's house, and his family was very generous and let us eat their cereal, because, of course, we're starving college children, so... We don't get to eat cereal much. But that's okay. But anyway, so we're just doing more Mount Crenel.
Climb, 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 climb.
Okay, look at how fast he climbs forward, and then look at how much faster he climbs sideways.
He's able to dodge a bullet climbing sideways, and he like, can't even dodge a bird flying like 1 mile an hour.
Anyway, so right here, this not so suspicious wall is where you bomb. And then the sign, I think the sign says no bombing. But anyway, you come in here.
That doesn't make it obvious at all.
Yeah, there's a great fairy's fountain. So make sure you got your bombs equipped, which I already did. And throw one in there. Try to blow up the fountain and flood the mountain. And there's this fairy pops out. So she asks if you threw the golden bomb or the silver bomb, and you're supposed to pick neither. Don't do what I did.
As punishment, I'll electrocute you.
Pretty much. And then she takes away all your bombs. So anyway.
Time to travel back to
so then you go back to the Deku scrub that wanted to sell you bombs, and you go and buy some bombs. I love how he goes so much faster sideways.
It doesn't look like he's climbing sideways, like his arms are just like moving up and down.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna try to change the frame speed when I record so it doesn't have like crazy jumps in it.
Uh-oh. The elastic mushroom!
Oh! I did it with the rock!
Well, he somehow died.
I guess. He shot a rock at his face, that's what. That was a blue one. Once again, hoping for hearts. So this one you want hit with your sword, try to chop it down. So until Link's face looks like he's taking a giant poo.
Uh-oh. What be this?
Anyway, I think I explained already that if you double R on top of those, you don't have to watch the dopey cutscene. Sounds like the bird outside my house in the morning.
If you hit it by a raindrop, it'll do damage?
Oh my gosh,
come on, it's water!
Yeah, but you're like the size of your thumbnail.
Still.
I mean, look at that. Look at how big that rock is compared to you now.
I guess.
Alright, so don't screw up on this rock puzzle. It's not hard. You push this one, and you hear the victory sound. Don't push that one that way, that's done. Anyway, and then take your time. Wait, he's thinking about it. He's like, wait, I gotta go around that rock. I hate how far you have to push this rock. I thought about hitting my space bar, like my speed button, while I was doing this. Like right here, just go. Just all the way across.
Almost.
Oh, nope.
Oh.
You gotta go all the way over here.
He's like, wait, no, wait, up. Yeah.
Let me just push this one out of the way. That's all there is to it. I couldn't believe it when I did that. I was like, really?
Oh, I'm stabbed.
Get the red chicken. Get him. Oh, you walked right into that one. Oh. Don't mess up on this puzzle either. It's not hard. Try some of the block.
There's a fly in here!
Oh! Man, this is a boring episode. I'm not gonna lie. Really boring. I love how Link walks like he's a girl. Like he's got his arms to the side and he's like, da, 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 da. Gust jar you. Take your rock.
Oh. Shoot it back at you.
And then give me your money.
Yeah, I'll kill you for your money. Link's in the Mafia. Oh,
pretty much. I don't know when the Mafia started using gust jars, though.
Back in the Dizzy.
Yeah. Theoretically, this is the very first Zelda game, chronologically. Because before this game, there are no other games. Because this is the game where Link gets his hat, as you saw. It's Elzo. But then, the hat just turns into a regular hat. It's not a hat bird.
Good. He probably stabbed it at the end of this game to shut it up.
He's like, oh, no! I hate you!
Link's philosophy to killing enemies. Swing sword wildly!
Pretty much. It's like the best philosophy in the world.
Just sucking up a random...
Switch. It's a switch.
Switch over now.
Yeah. Eventually you do get a tiger scroll that lets you break pots with your sword. It just gives me bombs. I don't want bombs. Boom.
Plus five.
Take my plus one mace. From Futurama.
Yeah.
What do I do when I get there? Now look what you've done. Oh, I'm getting trapped.
Oh, he's getting cornered. Oh.
Spin attack for the win. Oh, there was 20 rupees in that one.
We just got the empty bottle there.
Hey, that was a great investment. I think off screen I'm going to go and do that Kuko game again. Try to get some more rupees and get that boomerang.
For 300.
It's pretty useful, though.
Yeah.
Yeah. A lot of people say that the boomerang is usually the most useful item in the game. Just because it paralyzes enemies. I haven't played Twilight Princess yet, but I hear that there's like a tornado boomerang in that one.
Yeah, it's pretty sweet.
It's supposed to be like amazing. That and like the twin hook shot or whatever they call it. The claw shot or whatever. I'm like, dude, that's amazing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a sweet game. I haven't played it. My brother has, though.
I kind of, like, spoiled it for myself because I watched all the boss battles. Goma's in it. Like, they couldn't pick any other boss to put in the game, so I have to pick Goma again.
Why not?
No, go back for that heart, punk.
Don't get it.
Oh, I'm going to go back and get more heart pieces in the next episode, too. I missed two heart pieces in Minish Wood. So I gotta go do that.
Little Link, what are you doing?
He can't get in. Don't kill these guys, they're three hits. They take forever. Just roll.
Just roll past these little punks.
And go through the strategically placed door. Into Melari Mine.
Mini Mine. Heyo.
It's like Oompa Loompas. Link doesn't even care.
Just going past him.
What is the audacity to go into a house?
Yeah, a random little house with beds and a table. the tables or the chairs don't even equal the number of beds.
Okay. Just runs right into him. Alright, so you want to talk to this really big one with the massive mustache.
Hey, green clothes and an odd hat. Might you be Jimmy?
I'm Melari. And I make swords.
Randomly, I'll make you a sword that'll change size like you.
I looked everywhere online to see if you could only infuse one element into the Cori blade, but you can't because the blade's not finished until you beat the Fire Temple. Oh, how Link only has one piece, but then the tip of it magically appears.
Yep.
And then they don't even put it in the fire and it turns orange.
Don't ask questions.
Don't mess with the Minish. Watch. As soon as they hit it, it turns orange.
Hey!
Three times.
Alright, see you next time.
See ya.
We're gonna go to the Fire Temple.